Good morning students, welcome back to computer science classes of class 12. Today in this session we will be learning some MySQL. We will be actually revising the MySQL concepts that we have already done in our class 11. Okay, so let us see what are the things that we are going to do. This will be basically the practical approach. We will be learning how to create database, how to use it, how to show the databases that all we are existing, and how to drop it. Then we will learn how to create a table, alter a table, and drop a table, basically deleting the whole table. Now let us see how to open it. You have to basically have the MySQL. You can see MySQL 8.0 we are having over here. Now first, the moment you'll click in, you will get this screen. Then the moment you'll enter your password, I have entered root, and then you have got it. Now how to create the database? The query is create database, database name, and to open it we have to write the query as use database and database name. To show it, we will be write databases. So show databases. And if you want to show the different types of tables that are existing in that particular database, then we will write show tables. And if you want to drop the database, then we'll write drop database, database name. Now we'll see one by one the outputs. To show all the databases, you can see over here show databases, you'll get database, and these databases we are having information schema, MySQL, performance schema, and sys. Okay, now we have to create a database, so we'll write create database CSIP. Then if it is executed properly, then you'll get query okay, one row affected, and then now show the database. When we'll write show databases, you'll get all the databases, and you'll also get the database that we have just created as CSIP. Now we want to work with that database that we have created, CSIP, so we'll write use CSIP. Now inside the CSIP, what are the tables we are having? We'll just check it. So with for that we'll write show tables, and it is showing empty set. That means no table has been created as of now. So now what we are doing, we are dropping the database just to check how it works. So we'll write drop database and database name. Now show databases. So this, see, you can see over here that it is dropped. It is no more existing. CSIP database is no more existing. Okay, now we will learn what are the different types of queries. You all know that the SQL is of three types, right? The structured query language is of three types. One is the DDL, that is data definition language. Then we have DML, that is data manipulation language, and the last one we have got TCL, that is transaction control language. Now today we will be learning DDL, that is DDL, that is data definition language. Under that we'll run create, alter, and drop. So starting with create table name, and then column name, data type, and the size. Again, any other column name, data type, the size. Now let us see how it runs in the MySQL console. So create table, and if I say enter, then I'll get error, no database is selected. So first what we have to do, we have to use a database first. Okay. So what we are going to do, we will use CSIP. So we'll write use CSIP and you can see the database has changed. Now after that we will write create table, table name, then the column name, the size. We have to write primary key because I want to fix it as primary key, the data department number. Then department name, char, the size, not null. Not null constant, all of you know, it will specify that it has to be every time a data as data name, right? And then department loc as the location and then varchar 15. So with this, you can see a table is created. Now, if you want to create another table, you can create in the same way. Create table, table name, admission number, integer, primary key, the same way how we use. Okay, you can see over here, it is a foreign key that has been created with the constraints. I'll just explain. The admission number, you can have the primary key as constant over here, and then the default. That stream char default arts. So if anyone does not gives as the stream, then arts will be the default stream. And then marks integer 3, then check, that the check constant we are having, check marks equal to, marks is greater than equal to 0 or marks is less than equal to 100. So it will check the constant, whether it is check constant, whether the marks that we are entering is between 0 and 100. Then the department number, integer, 4 references, department, department number. This is the foreign key that we are creating for this table student. Earlier we were having the table called department, DEPT, depth, and here in this table we are having student. So there we have seen department number as the primary key over here, and here the admission number as the primary key. So department number will be the foreign key. Now let us see how to describe it. The syntax is DESC table name to describe the table. So the moment you will write DESC and the table name, you will get this thing. You will get this thing. Okay. The screen. Now DDL queries, the second one, alter table. We have learned how to create the table. Now we'll see how to use the alter table query. It is basically used to add new field to the table, to drop an existing field from the table, and to modify or change any existing field like the data type, the size, or the name as well. And some more thing we can do with this alter, you can add new constraint, you can drop existing constraint and modify or change the fields constraint. Let us see. Now create table, table name. We have created a table. And you will get as admission number, CSN name, DOB stream, marks, depth number. If you describe this, you can see over here. If you write DESC student, then you will get this whole set of table, right? Now, let us see what are the different things what we can do with their syntax and one example. To add new column, you have to write alter table, table name, add column name, data type, size and constraint name. Let us see the example. Over here, alter table, table name, add the new column name as address, the data type and the size. The moment you'll execute this, this will be entered inside the table. Earlier you have seen the existing table is having admission number, serial S name, DOB, stream, marks and depth number. Address was not there. So we are adding a new column with the help of this query. Now if you want to modify any existing column or its data type or size, so what we will write? Alter table table name, modify column. So existing column, you have, if you want to just change or modify the data type or size of the existing column, then you have to use modify keyword. And if you want to add a new column, then you will use the add as the keyword. Okay, so column name, then new data type, new size, and then first and after column name. Let us see how to write the query. Alter table table name, that is the fixed one, and then you write modify S name. We want to change the S name data type. Earlier the data type of S name was worker 30. Now here we are writing worker 30, not null. It was null earlier, right? Just see over here, S name, it is null. But now we want to change the constraint. So we are writing the same data type, the size, and then we are writing the new constraint, that is not null. Now if you want to change the name of the existing column, what you will write? Alter table table name, change column name, and then old name, then new name and column definition. Now let us see what is the example that we can have. Alter table table name, change, that is the keyword, then department number, we want to change it. The existing name is department number. The last column, that is, you can see over here, I'll just mark it over here. This one, department number, we want to make it as D number. And then the data type and the size that you want to have it. Okay. Now moving to next, we have got, if you want to drop or delete an existing column, then you write alter table table name, drop column name. Okay, so what you'll write? Alter table table name, drop DOB. So DOB will be deleted or removed from the existing table. I hope this is clear to you, all of you. Now next we have got, suppose we want to add a unique key constraint. Now for unique key constraint, what you'll be doing? Alter table table name, add constraint, unique column name 1, column name 2, whatever columns you want to have. So what you'll be writing over here? Alter table table name, then add constraint, unique, and then the particular column name. So address will be having unique constraint. So unique unique in bracket address. Now moving to next, we have got, if you want to drop any primary key constraint to a column, then what you'll write? Alter table table name and drop primary key. The primary key will be deleted. So you'll write alter, it is not shown over here. You'll write alter table table name, drop primary key. The moment you'll write it, the primary key will be deleted. Okay. If you run this, you can see earlier the primary key was admission number, Adam number, right? So it was deleted. Now to add a primary key, we have learned how to delete it, but if you want to add it, what you will do? Alter table table name, add primary key, and then column name. So you'll write alter table table name, add primary key, and suppose Adam number. The moment you'll run it, it will be again added with primary. Okay, Now the third one we have got drop a table. Drop table name, or we can also write drop table if exist that particular name. So we'll write drop table name, it will be deleted. So with this, our session for today ends. If you have any doubt, do let me know. I hope the session was fruitful and enjoying. Stay tuned for the upcoming videos wherein we will be learning the next SQL commands. Thank you.